Hey guys, today I'd like to show you how to build a Kanban board for your Scrum or Kanban team. So to get started, all you need is some loose painter tape, some Sharpies, and a bunch of post-it notes of various sizes and colors. So you use a Kanban board on your team to visualize the workflow so that the team can track the work that they're actually working on. So the first thing I like to do is to build a horizontal row for the Kanban board first, and then create four vertical columns. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so now you've created your first Kanban board, and now you need to label each of the column states. The first column is your backlog. This is your master backlog for the project. Highest priority items go high, and lower priority items go low. Next column is the to-do column. Then the in-progress column, and then the done column. This is the simplest Kanban board to implement. Shows each of the statuses. Now you want to populate your backlog. You use story tickets. I like to put a certain amount of information on my story tickets. I like the title, an XYZ user story format, definition of done, points. You might put acceptance criteria on them, and you can even use the back of the ticket if you need extra room for information. So let's populate our backlog. And you can even use different colored tickets to represent different types of stories. For example, this blue ticket might be a database story, and this green ticket might be an infrastructure story. So as you plan as a team, you take items and you put them into the to-do state. These stories here might represent your sprint backlog. And every day during your daily stand-up, the team gets together in front of the board and they take work and they move it through the different states. So now that we start working on this story, it gets pulled over. As this story gets worked on, it gets pulled over. You can even indicate ownership of stories by using avatars or sticky notes. For example, this orange sticky might indicate a specific person on the team, while this blue sticky might indicate someone else on the team. Stories get blocked. You can use a special flag to indicate blocked stories. This is a blocked story. And there's your flag that tells everyone that story is blocked. And then when this story is unblocked, simply remove the flag. As stories get worked on, you move them over to the done state. And you can even track emotional state of the team by using smiley face and frowny face avatars. This story was really fun to work on, while this story was terrible to work on. These are the basics of a Kanban board. I also like to use them as information radiators. Put as much information as possible about the project around the entire board. Every good board should have a project title, a code name, a logo. Display your team's velocity, whether it's burned up, burned down. Put up rules for the team, a global definition of done. Maybe team member names, email addresses, mobile phone numbers, and any visual artifacts that the team is producing, like designs or wireframes or schemas. The sky's the limit. Use your imagination, different colored tape, different colored stickies. You can even use drafting dots instead of tape. Just customize it to whatever suits your team the best. Thank you.